Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to another episode of Hard Spiral for Kaiserreich, the French Empire, vive la France, vive l'Empereur. So, we have returned to Paris. We are occupying our entire homeland, except a small part right here, which is Brittany, which is controlled by Kingdom of Ukraine. Yeah. And we also seem to forget about Wales, as some people commented down below, like, always forget about Wales. Don't worry, I won't forget about them. I will annex them too. So, for those of you who didn't watch my modern day Kingdom of Sweden, I will tune down the cringy speech a bit. It was way too much, even for me, last episode. But I will still keep them, because that had been a very big part of this series so far, but I will tune them down. So, how is the situation in the world? Since I didn't look very much on it last episode, I just made speeches all the time. So, United Communes of Brazil will most likely fall very, very soon. We just need some individual micromanagement right here, and they should fall within, well, a short amount of time. I have two units right here, so let's just have both of you attack right there and break that unit. Cool. So, how's it going? French, yeah, that's our territory. Nothing really strange going on. United States are pushing back with the help of Canada, which, well, it looked kind of bad for them, but it seems to be going quite well with the help of the Canadians. Right, you were? No, you were not getting... Oh, right, that was in the last war. This is the second civil war or something. All right. Yeah, I think at least. Maybe I'm actually messing up and thinking of different campaigns. Anyway, let's continue here, right here in Europe. People wanted to have just an overlook of the entire world, so that's basically what I'm trying to do right now. So, the Iranian Empire, the Axis is at war with the Ottoman Empire. The Ottoman Empire have destroyed, well, half of the nation right here, Saudi Arabia, right? But they have been, well, also losing quite a bit of land right here. So, I think the Ottoman Empire will fall from the Axis power. Dominion in India, right, I sent over more troops right here to actually help you push them back, while I only have 24 units stationed right here to invade the Commune of Britain. Let's see, how far are you along the way? You are down here in Africa, so yeah, quite soon before you actually, and I will just try to remove them as quickly as possible, then instantly send them back, because I'm probably gonna need more than 24 units to bring down Union of Britain. So, military factories, they're doing fine. People commented also that I didn't switch out my light tanks correctly. And no, I did not. I only switched out one line, apparently, to the Mark 1s. Motorized rocket artillery, so that's fine. How are we doing with light tanks? Quite decently. And motorized, really fine. Motorized rocket, not that fine. So, I tried playing this with the beta patch that is out right now, and it didn't work. The game crashed instantly. So if you have, and it also kind of corrupted that save. So if you have a Kaiserreich, well, save, don't load it up with release version. Just right-click the game, right-click Hearts of Iron. You go into properties, go into betas, and then you can select the 1.3.2 Torch Hotfix 2. So pick that one if you want to continue your Kaiserreich save. And now, that is it. Let's begin the game right now. We're gonna increase, I think, a tiny bit more motorized rocket artillery, because, well, we don't have that many of them. Oh, this is mostly destroyed factories, actually. So we won't actually get very many of them. Never mind. So, let's continue building here in Spain and try to fill up all the territory that we actually own with more factories. The rest can wait until we actually occupy the territory, so we don't have to just repair something that will just get destroyed by separatists and rebels once again. I don't have even some soldiers right there, no. Oh, here's the first 7 stack, and why do you have 2 cavalry units? Oh, right, these were the ones I actually got from the event, so let's just switch both of them out to actually something good. Our current division template are looking like 3 artillery, 9 units, engineer and support artillery. Our tank divisions are looking 6 light tanks, 8 motorized and 4 rocket artillery, with field hospital, engineering and support artillery. So, pretty good actually, and I think it would be very interesting to see if this actually work. They have pretty good soft attack. The only thing I'm kind of worried about is this armor. It's a bit too low for me. Though it should block at least normal infantry weapons, artillery with all the upgrades. But if they have anti-tank guns, I doubt this will actually hold. So later we might want to go like this. And if I haven't, okay, that's 21 armor. Have I upgraded light tanks armor to the maximum? Yes, we have. So we're probably not gonna get much more than that if we don't switch out the motorized, which we probably should, to some kind of mechanized. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see what's going on. All right, it's both of these we have to bring down actually. Ooh, that's gonna take a bit longer time, but I think we can deal with it. So let's just drag down this order and let's see, U7, the same with you. Just a general push order so I can attack however I want it. And how long before you are actually done with this? Okay, you're done right now. But you have one unit too much. Right, this one. I think I'm actually gonna remove one of you. You just want the bonuses, I want them to just have no penalties at all, or as few penalties at all when we finally now invade them. And I think actually I will try with these 24 units. Hopefully my units are so good, so the French willpower can push through and actually bring them down. Because the elan we have is pretty high right now. Reconquering the entire homeland and some more. Union of Britain, you have no chance. So let's try it. We have complete naval dominance, so that shouldn't be any trouble. Let's just double check. Friendly ship 68, enemy ships 0. And we also have air superiority right here, so we'll hopefully also breach right there. Okay, all of you that are currently standing back, I want to select all of you. And I want you all to... you landed first, so you all should... actually, why did I make another order? I want all of you to just, as quickly as possible, get right there. You, 5 divisions, have you landed? Cool. I'm gonna take 2 of you to attack right there. I'm gonna take 1 here. I'm gonna hit 1 here. Actually, that I don't have enough troops for that. 5 units were not enough. So just 1 unit everywhere, basically. Just to be able to extend this breachhead as much as possible. But this one is the most important province. So let's try to bring you down. I'm gonna send 3 divisions right here. 2 divisions right, or 1-1. So just get that port, because that's the crucial one. If we don't get that one, then we can't even retreat if we have to. Okay, cool. That's done. All of you get over here. And since we have that, I'm gonna just tell everyone, fix this. Popularity rising. Do we need it? No, we don't need this. So all of you get over. How is the supply right here? Yeah, it's gonna be excellent. Even when all the soldiers have... well, come right here. U3 division, please push right here. Otherwise, it can be a bit too easy for them to actually push us out. So we need to break that. Let's send in the tank too. Hopefully that should be some bonus damage. Yeah, that's gonna be pretty good. But they seem to have pretty awesome units themselves. Okay, NATO recruitment. That means we have more soldiers standing right here. Or somewhere around here at least. We're gonna switch you out to normal infantry. And let's see, where do we have them? We can check right here. Okay, select, 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 select. And that should include you two. Good. And all of you are going to be assigned right here. And you're going to be sent over quite soon. Well, to Union Britain. Let's see, we need a kind of good commander. All of you are old. maybe you should actually be assigned to this guy. And then we'll send both of them over one... no, I think we need more troops right here. But first of all, we need this breachhead. And this is way too unsure. Come on, let's see. They have... this vision can pierce enemy armor, so they can pierce my armor. But hopefully this might be able to make them overstate the amount of armor we have, so they might build too much anti-tank guns. You gotta see this at positive side. But I still think we can do some nice and funny stuff with these... very, very fast tank divisions. How's this going? We are surplus in tungsten. We are surplus in everything. Very, very nice. So we can stop trading steel, definitely. The same with aluminium. We still need the oil. No, we don't actually need that trade. And we need half our tungsten. Cool, that's fixed. And Dutch Middle Africa, you are right, you're with German Empire, so we shouldn't actually have to worry about you anything. You are just defending. No, you're trying to get here, and you, the garrison unit, you're just defending. Okay. So, have my troops arrived here yet? No, they're just arriving. Okay, cool. Just help them, hold out, try to just beat them down. Yeah, they actually just arrived. Let's see, how good are our divisions if we compare with them? It's actually quite hard. They're doing much better than I expected. I thought this coup would be kind of a rollover, but apparently not. Even our French troops are having trouble, but right here in Brazil, things are going much, much better. It would be really nice if we could just pull them back. That's still 12 divisions that could be doing something much, much better. Helping us either in Union Britain or down here in India. And how are, have you breached anything more? Doesn't seem like it. Since they have just so many more troops than us. We have the air superiority. Yes, we have it. But we need more. We need something more. Some... Okay, actually, we didn't. Oh, Germany landed. Nice. No. United Baltic Duchy. What? Where are you on the map? I don't actually know where they are on the map. Okay, I'm gonna have to look this out. So, United... Oh, here. Oh, right. United Baltic Duchy. Yes. Oh, I'm so stupid. Of course they're there. Ugh. Sometimes my brain is working a tiny bit slow. I hope you forgive me. At least Napoleon forgive me, so can't you? He's like looking kind of nicely at you. Just, yes, it's fine because you're taking over everything for me. So it's okay that you forgot about United Baltic Duchy. So... The lost traders are being rounded up, and the lost traders being rounded up. It's not that easy. We're actually fighting hard for every single province, and this might take a much, much longer time than I wanted. And we might even have to do more naval invasions. More naval invasions. What about you doing this invasion and trying to grab them a tiny bit from behind? At least, like, separate the units or just delay them, something that will just break up that wall of units they currently have. Alright, let's focus now a tiny bit more here in India, because it doesn't seem to be going that well right here. Especially since supply is something we seem to be lacking quite a bit. Let's see, break them right here, then we will continue pushing. Let's see how much of a penalty did we actually have in these battles. And that's them. We don't actually have a penalty right here. We don't have any troops up here. How come? Oh god, we have a massive disadvantage because the troops are untrained. Let's see, you should be doing a tiny bit better, but river crossing, decryption advantage, night terrain, yeah, they will have a much better... we'll have to try to break them down here because it seems to be the most reasonable position. Yeah, it seems like the Princely Federation are a bit worse than the Bahatian Commune. So I think we'll try to do our breaking right here. Bring down one nation at a time. You please continue this attack. Because if you break right here, then you can continue attacking right here. Just delay these units so I can break right here and instantly... continue that push to this province, which means we get over the river, which means we can hopefully bring these people down after that. No, continue this attack. Come on, you need to break them. So even while very quickly pushing against them, they still manage to hold us off. That's bad. That's very, very bad. This war is going to take a much higher engagement from me than I would actually like to give them right now. But right here seems to be going quite well. We actually assigned one of our tanks over here. And how are you doing in defense? Yeah, you're actually doing really well in defense. And you are not piercing that armor, so we should probably send out our tanks to India. Alright, we already have one right here. But I'm actually going to deploy lots of you ahead in time and just assign you to this division. And yeah, just get there. And how are you actually gonna get there? You're gonna go right here, then probably through this. We'll see. Come on, thanks. Yeah, okay, cool. And while you have actually been broken right here, that's very, very bad. Oh, luckily we have one right here, so it's not as bad as I thought, but still extremely bad that we actually lost it. I thought we would be able to actually hold this by ourselves. So let's see, are you done yet? Yes, you are. So let's push that right now, because we desperately need something that's going our way. Okay, we managed to take it back, and we took Bristol while they were moving out. So let's see if we can grab London. You are trying to push in, very, very good. You're holding on, but you managed to now push back right here. Okay. Oh, no, what are you doing? No, no. All of you guys are signed right there. All of you guys are signed right here. So you're not gonna do anything weird. You're gonna do exactly what I tell you and nothing else. You, attack right here. You, attack right here. We need one line. That's why I really wanted to push this division, or this province. So we'd have two lines at least, so even if they break one unit, we will have one extra. So one of you guys, please push in, or just push straight forward. Good, we got that division, got that province now. And that would be the very important, I think, in our push to actually try and fix this. Okay, you need to be attacking right here. As soon as you break, come on. Tiny bit more. Okay, one more unit. Come on, break. That's a bit too quick. That's a bit too quick. Okay, we will probably have to try and save them now. That's very, very bad, because I wasn't planning on trying to make aggressive push right here. But we might actually succeed with it if you don't fall and fail this province once again. Come on. Come on, get there. Good. You're defending. We actually won province from Britain right there, and you guys will probably just get killed off now, which is very, very bad. Now, excellent play of the AI, just keeping me occupied all the time with battles, and that really hindered me from actually attacking myself, which means, well, they will eventually run out of supply and then die. And there they went. Seven divisions of brave French troops from the French Empire died completely in vain. Well played, AI. But now you're gonna get that tenfold back. I will never rest until the troops have been avenged. You, haven't you really taken this single province yet? That's all that's needed until so Brazil falls. But you have been holding on very stubbornly. And right here in India, how's it going? We are at least holding them now. They're not pushing us back anymore. So waiting for new tanks, which, come on. What kind of timing do I have? I have perfect timing, apparently. And they just arrived. So let's see if we can do something right here. I think this will be our way of pushing in. Though right now we seem to have quite a bit of trouble actually doing it. You guys, please delay that unit and don't let them attack on the side. No, we're probably going to need some kind of air force assigned right here. But let's see, do we have any heavy fighters? Because you would have enough range. Okay, let's just do... What kind of air force do they have right here? Okay, nothing. Do you have air force right here? Some, but no fighters. So, yeah, good. 100 fighters deployed right here. And 100 tactical bombers, sure. Both of you. Actually, you don't have enough range, heavy fighters. Okay, I guess both of you are going to get deployed right here. And we'll see if we can do something here instead. 24 units assigned right here, and we can't actually see right here. 14 divisions, good. Everyone is assigned at least correctly. So, should I just make a general push? I don't want to do a general push here, because they seem to have quite a bit of nice advantages. They dig in, they have the supply, they have everything they need to actually hold me off right now. So we'll have to fix that somehow. While right here, we took London. Very, very nice. Well done. Well done, troops. You're doing exactly as you should. And that's it? Oh! They could not have had very much national unity. Taking London and, I guess, Bristol was enough to make them fall. Well, no! This is the United Communal Brazil. Alright. Alright, that was... Okay. That kind of explains it. So let's see. Which province do I not care about? We should be able to basically take almost everything we want. Okay, I don't care about that. Let's just end the turn. Are you taking anything? No, it's only me taking stuff. So it's fine. And there we have it. United Communes of France. Brazil was the next. And now we have a very big, very nice French Empire left. And this means 12 more divisions. Hello, let's assign you right here to begin with. This is just an easy way. You can't just click here to get them right here. But if you make a small order, assign them, get over there, then they will fix everything by themselves. So instead of just moving normally, if I just want them to go to one province, just make a tiny, tiny order and then remove it once they have arrived. Remember that, that's very important. Remove it when once they have arrived, otherwise it can disrupt later. And it seems like I've been a bit bad on actually looking at my research and everything. I've been a tiny bit too busy with all the wars going on. So that's the negative part of playing speed 5, but playing speed 5 might get you some stuff unexpected. Like they managed to push right here, and it's kind of fun to actually break that back. But with the French troops and Napoleon, Vive Emperor, everything will be alright if we just stand together strong. So yeah, and it seems like music has been a tiny bit too high all this time. Hopefully that did not bother you too much. I still see it as too high. What the hell is it? Oh no, it was just bombing. Oof. It kind of made me afraid there that I'd completely messed up the entire episode. So, let's double check. We have the air support, we have everything. I don't want... Okay, Charles de Gaulle, I'm gonna give you this advance order. Please succeed. It's looking green, it's looking good. Okay, it seems Union of France, they were a kind of a force to be reckoned with. Lots of troops, small amount of military factories, especially now, and that means they can't keep it up. They can't keep up all this advance pushing. Let's see, how much have I actually lost right here? I just wished I had split up everything. Yeah, most likely they have lost about, let's check the last 4 months, much of that equipment. And I should be guessing that it's very little from here, very little from here, but most of it should have been right here. So they have lost a ton of equipment, and not all of them have been sitting on such an awesome stockpile as the French Empire. We were ready for war, we prepared for this for a very long time, and now we're striking back and taking it. And by the way, those episodes you made, you renamed all my Star Wars, or all my Kaiser's episodes to Star Wars episodes. Those were pretty good. Nice work. And yeah, now the worrisome part is coming. We are getting a tiny bit too big of a front line and we can't actually support it. And what the hell happened? Oh! When we took enough, it... Okay, this is some kind of event that is in Kaiserreich, so when they're about to fall, it seems like we turn it back to United Kingdom's Liberal Party under Bernard Badepem. Okay. Bernard Battenberg. So yeah, that was it. Our friends are liberated. And Dominion of Canada. Okay. Oh yeah, now we can make it finally the peace deal to retake our empire. So I'm kind of worried that Germany will actually grab parts of our stuff. And if they do, we'll of course have to reclaim it from them, those bastards. But what's really important, we need France. I don't care what else, Paris is ours again. We have returned to Paris and that's what we're going for at least. Even if it's not the most efficient territories. Let's see, I want these three. Okay, we'll wait a tiny bit with that one and just take these. Yeah, that works. What do you take in? You take Friesland. Alright, I want to grab that and this, Normandy. Okay, that's fine. Can I grab more? No. I'm just gonna try to reclaim as much as possible from our... enough of our former homeland to actually feel like it was worth it to retake everything. They're only taking Friesland. Alright. What? Really? If I pass... Pass again. I don't actually see them taking anything. It seems like the AI has been restricted to not take anything from Paris because it's mine. And this is apparently the good thing about playing mods where the pieces are kind of already done. I don't actually have to worry about anyone stealing my territory, because it's said that I should take it. Nice. And it seems like I will grab most of this territory too. Alright. Is there anything more you would like to give me? Oh, the princely states. Yeah, I can grab that too. Yeah, sure. I won't actually complain about it. And turn and coming to France. It seems like we have even more territory to grab. And thank you for that. And let's see. So, Dominion of India took 7 states, French Empire took 37 states, Germany took 1 state, and a lot of people were next. So, the French Empire has finally established it world domination. No, not world domination, but very, very soon. We will take it. I first thought this was us. I was like, no, that's kind of us. So, we have parts of India, we have Nepal, we have Afghanistan, we have, well, much of South Africa again. We have taken back South Africa, and I selected South America. South Africa, I don't think we have expanded anything right here, but we will when we clear one Germany, since, as you can see, we're missing 2 states, and the French Empire will not tolerate for anyone having our territory. We need to reclaim our homeland. So, yeah, this Napoleon wanna be a bit better than the old Napoleon, the Napoleon's war. So we will reclaim his land. And we have expanded here in South America. Let's see, are there any valuable resources we have gained from it? Some, but mostly a lot of manpower. We have 800,000 right now. I thought we were gonna get a massive boost when we eventually reclaimed Paris, but seems like not. And I can't actually end the episode on this. I absolutely refuse to end the episode right now. No, you can go to hell, it's arms. You know what I have to do before we actually end this episode. We can finally say that we have succeeded in what we at least begun with setting out to do. After many years of exile and struggle, finally the 4th French Republic, finally the French Empire under Napoleon has reclaimed its rightful land. With Paris proper back in our hands, we can return the City of Lights and reclaim our position. Go to hell. Liberate Italian Republic. Liberate. Return it to a loyal ally. So, liberate to the Kingdom of 2 Sicilies. So, what do we want to do right here? Liberate Italian Republic. Socialist Republics. Oh, no. We can probably influence them to actually become better. So, we're gonna liberate the Italian Republic. Alright, we can return the City of Lights and reclaim our position among the leading nations of the world. That was interrupted several times by several things, so I'll probably reread it once when we're actually done with it. So, right here, Italian Republic is under us. Oh, okay, that's kind of fine actually. So, we have a nice Italian puppet, so we'll have to reclaim the lands for them too. We could probably make Spain some kind of puppet. If I allow them, like return it to our friends, will it be a puppet of ours, or will it actually be independent? Because if it is a puppet, then I might actually accept it. So, return to Paris, reconquest of France, remove national spirits. Okay, that's fine. The reconquest of French proper, and after this, restore the suspended constitution. No, never. Stay with absolutism. That's what we're gonna do. Absolutism. Ugh, God. Why is some words hard for me to say? I don't know. Probably because I'm Swedish. So, let's just return all our troops. Everyone should be returning. Let's just remove all your front lines. And make sure that happens with every single one. Because all French troops should be allowed to return to Paris. Except the garrison units. They should still stay right where they are in Africa. For now, at least. Soon, but everyone just return to Paris, because everyone needs to be there when we finally make it happen. It took us, well, 6 episodes, and I'm kind of proud. It looks nice. We have expanded the territory quite a lot. Much in the world has actually blown up, and civil war, and the Russian Empire has finally united once again. So the Dakar Algiers Airways goes bankrupt. Arrest the managers, or this is our fault. Remove one civilian factory. Remove one civilian. Arrest the managers, of course. It was never our fault. We never did anything. Three military factories. Yeah, that's a nice big amount of extra civilian factories. So what are we missing most critically to make our dream of a very light, heavy force the reality? What we're missing most are rocket artillery, maybe, but we can still add a ton of these lines. So since we're getting so much light tanks, because light tanks are very, very cheap to produce, and we can even upgrade them a tiny bit more. Let's see. We can do this. That's 96% reliability. Some more soft attack. Just a tiny bit more, but I think I'm actually gonna wait a bit more until I can upgrade them even more before I switch them out. I want a good, nice pile of light tanks extra right now. Yeah, all of you are just gonna be deployed right here, and I will soon assign you. You will be very, very much needed when I invade the German Empire to retake our own land. So, return Paris, another 40 more days. We're gonna get 200 power from that. That's awesome. And I can finally... Oh, actually, limit export. We were already there. I was thinking of modern day campaign once again. So, what did we exactly get from here? Actually, a ton of military factory and stuff like that. Probably a bunch of manpower too. Yeah. And right here from Nepal, we have... Well, a good amount of civilian factories. Afghanistan, pretty decent land. Yeah, we have taken a bunch of nice land, actually. It's not super nice here in Brazil, but we can rebuild it a lot to have it a very nice industrial base in South America. So almost all troops have returned. We have a couple more that are coming on right now, and let's actually have them in kind of nice formation, because the reclaimers of Paris should be first. Let's see, U-24 can be right around them. And actually, you also need to be, well, assigned right here. Cool, and let's see, U-12, you can be standing right there, like a half circle. And U-14, you can be like this, a bit larger half circle. And then let's remove both these lines. Assign U-14 right here, assign U-12 right here, and see if that happen or if that works. If I only could assign like my Napoleon as one unit and assign it to Paris, that'd be awesome, but I think this will have to do. The French Empire's returned to Paris, and we have succeeded with the first mission, so it's time for us to be a bit more free. We have done our first conquest, so what would you like, guys, to see the French Empire to do next? Reclaim our own land against the German Empire? Should we go against China, or split up China? Or should we kill the United States because they didn't help us? They were involved in civil war. I will leave that up to you. Write in the comments down below what you think we should do. And let's return to Paris now. With after many years of exile and struggle, finally the French Empire under Napoleon have claimed its rightful land. With Paris proper back in our hands, we can return the City of Lights and reclaim our position among the leading nations in this world. God damn it, I was trying to time it perfectly with the event finishing. But we managed to time it perfectly to 1st of January 1942. So, the reconquest of French proper. After many years struggle, the same. Back to Paris, a splendor awaits. And this will give us move capital to Ile-de-France. We will remove some military factories, actually. But gains core on everything, that will increase our manpower. That was what I was waiting for. So, thank you guys for joining me for this episode. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, and bye.